Hello, folks. Welcome to tonight's game. This one's going to be good between the Michigan State Spartans and the Louisville Cardinals. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
There might not be lights in the arena after the game if these two guards shoot them out like they're capable of.
Buckle up, folks. Here we go. Louisville gets the ball and begins their threat. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Missed the jumper. Valentine receives the ball. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Knocked it down.
That'll take some pride on the defensive end.
They're working around the arc. The senior commits a turnover. Moving it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. He puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
They move it into the front court. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The Cardinals are going into their zone motion offense now.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive.
Rejected. Oh, that zone put a stop on that shot.
Hey, this group is ready to collapse on any inside shots. They're saying, not today, young fellas, not today. Turnover by the senior.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong.
They're working around the perimeter. Seconds on the shot clock. And he missed. The shooting guard takes the pass. He shoots from the top of the key. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
The fans are really satisfied with what's taking place out there on the court. What a reaction.
Hey, that reaction says it all. These fans are ecstatic, Brad.
The Cardinals go into their zone motion now. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Bust the J.
lot of pressure on him. Basketball. Play the ball. Tough. Drive him, beat him, turn him, beat him to his spot.
Nick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers. Shooter spotting up on a three.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Looking for a good shot. Blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Number zero picks up the foul. First personal foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
It around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Trying to pack it inside. For the bucket. Knocks it down. And now they'll bring it up. The Cardinals are looking, Dick, to force a tempo by extending their defense.
You know, forcing your opponent to play in a full court is a great idea if you have the athleticism to play that style, Brad. Otherwise, you may not be very successful pressuring in the full court.
Harrell handles the pass. Nails the J.
There's the trap.
Harris handles the feed.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Way out on the right wing. Trying to feed the low block. In the lane. Off the mark. The point guard gets the ball. Had a momentary look from three-point land. And we'll get a change of possession. They've got him right where they want him, Dick. The crowd voices their approval. What a response they're getting.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion. They work the perimeter. Let's it fly. Can't connect. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Harris handles the feed. They look to get it to the inside for two. Not this time. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Missed it. Down in the low block, try to work inside. They get it to go.
Inside.
Tries for two. He hits the shot. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
Harris receives the ball. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. That's good. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. The center with the ball. The missed shot for the bucket. You betcha. There's a double team waiting there. Gave it up. Number zero grabs it. The Cardinals are on the run. Turnover committed by the freshman. Harris receives the ball. He tries the three ball. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper. Nope. He takes the board. The Cardinals are considered pretty balanced, I think, when talking about their style of play. Wouldn't you say, Dick?
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
Hey, you know, he's been excellent, Brad. He's been efficient. He's been focused. What a gutty performance. And given his team a great chance to win.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Gets the J to fall. On the outside. For two. He can't get the bucket to fall. We're at the 5 minute mark. Gave it up. There they and the block. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Here they go in transition. Goes up for two. Tickles a twine. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Timeout on the floor. ESPN's coverage of the NCAA will continue after this. We're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. They work it around the perimeter. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
time. Handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. With the J. And come up short. The small forward gets the pass. On the outside. Turnover committed by the senior. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the tray. Three balls paying dividends tonight, Dick.
That's right, Brad. All their bills are getting paid from New York, baby.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And no good. On the left side. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. Valentine receives the ball. The ball stripped. We're at the 2 minute mark. Now looking to attack. Farrell handles the feed. Inside. Goes up with it. Knocks it down. The Cardinals seem like they want to play this game at the next level on defense, Dick.
Hey, look out for the full court pressure, Brad. It'll be interesting to see how the pressure will be handled.
For two, he can't get the hoop to fall. He goes for three.
Jumping didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
About a minute remaining.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the corner. They got it. Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. Tries for two. It's good. Time to pick up the defense here now. Shot clock is dead. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Goes up with a shot. Off the mark. Moving around the perimeter with a big shot and off the mark. At the half, the Spartans are behind by seven. Louisville showed great presence on the boards in the first half.
And you know what really impressed me, Brad? They did it with textbook box out form. They sealed off. We see so many kids that don't box out. Not this team.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. They're working around the arc. Puts up the J. Nails the jumper.
He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. Gave it up. launches the three. He drains the jumper. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Cardinals, they've done a great job at the offensive end. Specifically, they were able to push the ball in transition and exploit the opposition's inability to get back on defense. Dick, you mentioned this earlier as an important point, and sure enough, it's made a difference. Let's see if they can keep it up in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Moving it around the perimeter. And we've got a change in possession here. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Traps in place, Dick. Shot clock. He puts it up quick to beat the clock. Can't connect. And work it into a double team on a post.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. That was nice. They're working around the perimeter. It on the floor and up and under. Nope. He gets the rebound. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The point guard gets the ball. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
For the bucket, off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. He blocks the shot. Gave it up. For two. Sinks the shot. Here's a double team. On the dribble, gives it up. They run it up into transition. Tries for two. He gets it to go. Nice pass to the low block. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Nails the J. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. They go into the low block. He attempts the jump shot. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
for the bucket. Off the glass and no good. No good. Off the glass and no good. Working it around the perimeter. Quick hand. And a momentary look from three-point land. Wow, the horrific shooting continues.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
He shoots the jumper, scores it. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
I think when you have balance, inside, outside scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo.
Around 8 minutes remaining.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Way out on top, controlling the ball for two. No good. Freedom Hall is going mad. Top of the circle, they work it. Goaltending called. The Cardinals have been getting contributions from a whole bunch of players here today.
It really takes the pressure off of your go-to guys when the supporting cast is able to make plays, rebound, and be strong on defense. As a coach, when your team is playing together like this, you have to be smiling on the sideline.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. They work the perimeter. He attempts the three. Missed the jumper.
Inside.
The freshman commits a turnover. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Harris handles the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Missed it. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
They've got him trapped. He may be in some trouble here.
Turnover City, that'll always really negate any offense.
On the outside. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
The Cardinals want to up the pressure here, Dick, and I think they're going to change the tempo of the game with their defense.
You know, it's a great decision, Brad, if you have the right personnel to play full-court defense.
The Cardinals are going into their zone motion offense now. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He nails the bucket.
Pushing that basketball.
Number 20 comes up with it. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number 20 gets the pass. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick. Well, you got to think the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
Looking for a good shot from beyond the arc.
Excellent jump shot right there.
We're at the 5-minute mark. On the outside. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
They've got a player spotting up on the three.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With the jumper off the mark. Number zero gets the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Bust the J. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
For the bucket. Got it. About 4 minutes remaining. Gave it up. Puts up the jumper. And come up short.
Look at that spacing.
For two. He misses it. Tries for two. Drains it. They've been getting exactly what they want so far, and that's points in the paint, Dick.
They're making it look real easy right now, Brad. It's like playing against your little brother. Physically, they're dominating them inside. It's time for the defense to get tougher. Horrible interior defense so far.
Goes up for two. They just can't seem to get a nice look at the goal tonight.
They have to be patient on offense and find some easy hoops.
Remaining on the game clock. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Out on the wing. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. Scorches the net with a J. Jumper. Nope. They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. Can't put it down. Number 20 takes the pass. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the right side. for two. Off the glass and no good. Number 20 gets the pass. He puts up the J. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
They got it. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
Fed the low block. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Off the mark. Valentine handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Struggles with a close one. Goes up for two. Makes the shot. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
You can't forget about them. The witty humor and dedication to their teams. You can't find this in any other team sport.
Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Can't connect. Shot clock is dead. He shoots from the deep corner. The missed shot. Cross court. Here's a look at our players of the game.
Oh, some great performances here tonight. Just some special young men.